Let's meet the Drozdowski family. Norm, Beth, Jennifer, Frank, and Tom, ready for action.
All right. Yeah.
Playing against the Holtrust family. Steve, Pam, Ed, Julie, and Mark, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you so much, and welcome to Family Feud. I'm Ray Combs, the new host of the show. Happy birthday, America. Let me say that first of all. It's a pleasure to be with you. Today we're going to see two wonderful families battle it out for family honor on their way to $5,000, or the chance for $5,000. But I want you to know that I'm excited about being on CBS and hosting this show. I have been studying all the great CBS shows. I think I'm prepared. So if you're ready, let's have the first item up for bids. Wait a minute. That's the wrong show. Hold on. We're going to have a great time. Let's meet our first family, the Drozdowski family.
Yeah.
Hi. How are you doing?
Well, thank you.
Welcome to our show. Frank, who did you bring with you today?
I've got my wife, Beth.
Hi, Hello. Beth.
My daughter, Jennifer.
Hi.
My father-in-law, Norm.
Hi, Norm.
And my brother, Tom.
Hi. You're a great family. You look very sharp. Let's see who you're playing against. The Holtrust family. Hi, Ed. Let's just stand back to back for a second, Ed. Could we do that?
Sure, why not?
All right. Who did you bring with you, Ed?
My son, Steve.
Hi, Steve. Another Hello. Little fella.
My son, Mark.
Hi, Mark.
My daughter, Julie.
Hello.
Hi.
And my daughter, Pam.
Hi.
All right, welcome. Now, could I ask, where is your wife?
Well, she's 5'2", and so she's
still recovering from birth from these two,
that's
probably.
Right.
These some big fellows. This is unbelievable. You know, you guys were probably as big as me when you were conceived. That night, you were probably as big as me. We welcome you to the show.
Thank you. Good luck.
One of you families is going to get the chance to play for $5,000, and there's only one way to do it, and that's play the feud. Let's go. The first family, the $300, wins the game and gets the chance to play fast money for $5,000. We asked 100 people this question and the top five answers on the board. Try to find the most popular answer. Who is the most macho man in movies today? Frank.
Sylvester Stallone.
He says Stallone.
How about yo Adrian Stallone?
Number one answer. You have control. Go back with your family. You might get the chance to steal. If you do, think up some good answers so you can help the head of your family. Hi, Beth.
Hi.
Welcome to our show.
Thank you very much.
You're very lovely.
Oh, thank you.
You like these macho guys in the movie?
Yeah, I do.
All right. aside from me, who is the most macho man in movies today?
Burt Reynolds.
Burt Reynolds is a fine answer. Let us see if it's there. Yeah. How about Burt Reynolds? Yeah. Made the survey. Six people agreed with you. Hi, Jennifer.
Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Well, let's see. I'm going to have to say, I don't think I can pronounce his name, Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Yes. That's funny. That's funny. A girl with the name Drozdowski can't say Schwarzenegger. Schwarzenegger. Yeah. Number two. How about that?
Yes.
All right. Made the survey. Welcome, Norm. Who is the most macho man in movies today?
Oh, I gotta say, it's that Australian, but you know I can't think of his name.
I can't help you.
You can't help me at all?
No.
Hogan?
Hogan, he says? All right, okay.
Let's try it.
Let's try. He says Hogan. Let's see if it's there. How about Hogan? They're booing you, Norm. It was a fine answer. It was a good attempt. First strike. Two more, they're gonna get a chance to steal. Hi, Tom.
Nice to meet you, Ray.
Nice to meet you. Who is the most macho man in movies today?
One of my favorites, Clint Eastwood.
Let us see Clint Eastwood. It's there. 14 people agreed on our survey. Frank, back up to you. There is one answer there, and you only have one strike.
How about Tom Cruise?
Let's see Tom Cruise. Second strike. Folks, it's turning ugly now. Beth, the pressure is on you.
Yeah, it is. How about Mark Harmon?
How about him, okay?
Yeah.
If Mark Harmon is there, you take the bank. If not, the whole trust get the chance to steal that bank. Let's see Mark Harmon. It is not there. You get the chance to steal. I'm going to ask you very quickly to give me one answer that might help the head of your family. Pam?
Tom Selleck.
She says Tom Selleck. Julie?
Charles Bronson.
Charles Bronson. Mark?
Kevin Costner.
Kevin Costner. Oh. Steve?
Bronson.
Bronson? Mm-hmm. Charles Bronson? Bronson? Ed, there are some fine answers there. You don't have to take those. You're the head of this family. You can choose anything you would like.
Oh, I think I'll go with Pam, with Tom Selleck.
Tom Selleck.
Oh, all right.
If Selleck is there, you take that bank. If not, it goes to the Drozdowskis. Tom Selleck. You take the bank. You take the bank. It goes to the Holtrust. They strike first. $62 for the Holtrust. Zero for the Drozdowskis. We're going all the way to $300. Don't go away. There's a lot more.
Who is the host of
Calm?
Good luck to both of you. We asked 100 people this question, the top six answers on the board. Try to find the most popular answer. Name something that's harder to do the older you get. Beth, she says run. Let's see run. Did not make the survey. Steve, can you give me one of those answers?
Who?
Who? Very quickly.
Eat.
He says eat. I can see you're concerned about that, Steve. But I don't know if it made the survey. Let us see. Eat. It is not there. We go now to Jennifer. Can you give me an answer?
Walk.
She says walk. All right. How about walk? Not there. We come over to Mark.
Lose weight.
You know, just like, again, something else you should be thinking about, Mark. Mark says losing weight. It is there. You have the board. You may get the chance to steal this question. Pick us some great answers. You know what? I'm very surprised. I would think this is a very easy question, but we will see. Julie, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Drive.
Say drive. Name something that's harder to do the older you get. Didn't stop Mr. Magoo, did it? He just kept like those driving that car. We will see. She says drive. How about drive? Not there. Pam, how are you?
Fine, thanks.
Name something that's harder to do the older you get.
Read.
To read.
Or see.
I think that's a fine answer, and I bet it's there. How about reading? Did not make the survey. That is their second strike. One more. They're going to get the chance to steal, Ed.
Okay, I think it's exercise.
To exercise. If it's there, you're still alive in this question. If not, the Drozdowski is going to get the chance to steal. He says exercise. The number one answer. There you go, Father. 31 people agreed. Steve, there are four very fine answers up there. Can you just give me one of them?
How about hear?
How about hearing? There it is. All right, very funny. Mark, your family needs you.
Let's say get around.
To get
out of the house.
Get out of the house. Strike three. We come across for the opportunity to steal. Once again, I will ask you to give me one answer to help the head of the family. Tom.
Work.
He says work. Norm.
Sex.
Norm says sex. Okay. You look like a sex demon, Norm. Jennifer?
I have no idea.
No idea. Beth?
Play sports.
She says play sports. Frank, you can take any of those answers or pick your own. Which
Looks sound pretty good, but I think I'll try sex.
You're going to say sex. Something, okay, but we'll see if it's up. If sex is there, you take that bank. If not, it goes to the Holtrust family. How about sex? It's Beth. You, the Drozdowski, take the bank.
I knew it'd be the home.
There are two things that we did not know. Number four.
Remember.
We couldn't remember those answers. And number five. Bend over. No comment on that one. The Holtrusts have 62. We come over to the Drozdowskis, who have 48. We're going all the way to $300. I wouldn't go away.
Can't fall asleep, or do you?
Top five answers on the board. What do you think is America's most popular food? Jennifer.
Pizza.
She says pizza. Right. How about pizza? It's the number two answer. One will beat it, Mark. If you can give it to me, you control that board.
Hamburgers.
He says hamburgers. Let us see hamburgers. Number one. You can go back with your family for this deal. Let's go right over this way. Julie, what do you think is America's most popular food?
Hot dogs.
She says hot dogs. Well, let's see hot dogs.
Yeah.
It's there. Five people in the survey agree. Pam?
Tacos.
Tacos. How about tacos? Did not make it. It's only your first strike. Two more opportunities. Ed, you don't look like you know a lot about food. Just give me one of those answers.
I'd say it was a steak.
You say steak. All right.
Yes.
How about steak? That surprises me. That is your second strike. You need this to stay alive in this question, Steve.
I'm going to say French fries.
French fries. Yeah. If they're there, you're still alive. If not, third strike. The Drozdowskis get that chance to steal again. French fries. Whoa, that is the third strike. And surprising, we come over once again for a very quick help for the head of the family. Tom.
Ice cream.
Ice cream. Norm.
Ice cream.
Ice cream. Jennifer.
Chinese food.
She says Chinese. Very American. And Beth.
Ice cream.
Ice cream. Frank, any of those?
Gotta go with ice cream.
Let's see. Ice cream. It is not fair. Holtrust, get that back. 153 to 48. Let's go. We got two more answers there that we did not... Two answers that we did not know. Number four.
Fried chicken.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And number five.
Pasta.
Well, I'd say it's time for another face-off. Let's go, Julie. Norm. 153 for the Holtrust. The Drozdowskis have 48. This is a very important question. The dollar values are doubled. Here we go. The top four answers on the board. Name an occasion when people put up special decorations. Julie.
A wedding.
She says wedding. Let's see wedding. It is not there. Norm, can you give me one of those four answers?
Christmas.
He says Christmas. How about Christmas? It is the number one answer. Julie, go back with your family. We come right on to Tom. Tom, name an occasion when people put up special decorations.
New Year's.
New Year's. Did not make the survey. That is your first strike.
Frank.
Halloween.
Halloween. Yeah. Let's see Halloween.
Right.
Made the survey. Beth.
Birthday party.
She says birthday.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let us see birthday.
It's right, right.
Number two. Jennifer?
How about an anniversary party?
Anniversary. Not there. I must point out to you, Norm, there's a lot of pressure on you. Name an occasion when people put up special decorations.
Thanksgiving.
He says Thanksgiving. If it's there, you take the bank. If not, they get that chance to steal and for the game. Thanksgiving. Very important opportunity here for the Holtrust family. Help the head of your family.
Pam? Hanukkah.
She says Hanukkah. All right, Julie.
A shower.
A shower.
Easter.
Easter. Steve?
Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day.
Oh.
Ed, there are some very fine answers there, but you can pick your own if you'd like.
Well, I think I'm going to go with these hearts here. I'll go Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day. If it is there, you take that bank and win this game. If not, it goes to the Drozdowski family. He says Valentine's Day. Drozdowski, you take that bag. $234. One answer that we did not know. Number three.
Easter.
If you had listened to Mark, you would have won this game. Here we go, the final question. Come on down. Pam. Tom. Shake hands. Tom, be a nice guy. Very important question. The dollar values are tripled. Whoever wins this question will win the game and play fast money for $5,000. The top three answers on the board. Name the gift women most love men. You must answer.
Diamonds.
She says diamonds. How about diamonds? It is the number one answer. Tom, you can go back with your family. She's psychic. Very important question. You can win the game. I will finish reading the question for you now, Ed. Name the gift women most love men to give them.
A new home.
A new home.
Oh,
all right.
Home.
Seems like a desperate answer there. Let's see home. That is strike one. There are two answers there, Steve.
Flowers.
Flowers. Yeah. How about flowers? It's there. 32 people agree. Mark, one answer will win this game for you.
The other one's got to be candy.
Candy.
Oh. I've got it.
Pressure on you, Julie.
I've got it.
All right.
Perfume.
Yes,
perfume.
It is.
If it's there, you win the game. Yeah. If not, they're going for the steal. How about perfume? Drozdowski's big opportunity here. Tom, help the head of the family.
Clothing.
He says clothing. Norm has no answer. You have one?
Food.
Food. Jennifer?
Clothing.
Clothing. Beth?
Lingerie.
Lingerie. Frank, there are some answers there, but you can go off on your own.
No, I've got to try clothing.
You say clothing. If it's there, you take the bank, win the game, play for $5,000. If not, goes to the Holtrust.
Come on.
How about
clothing?
Holtrust, you win the game. You win the game. Number three, money. Listen, you have a lovely family. We're sorry you did not win. You've got $250. Thank you for playing. I need two players for $5,000. Who's it going to be? Steve, you playing first?
Yeah.
All right, come with me. We're going to take Julie off stage. Don't go away. The Holtrust just won the game. They're playing for $5,000. And we come back.
Up next, families have been feuding 16796 or visit SoClean.com today.
Steve, you know how this works.
Yes,
we've taken your sister Julie off stage. She's unable to hear the questions I'm about to ask you. I'll ask you five questions. You try to give me the most popular answer. You have 15 seconds to answer. If you and your sister pile up 200 points, you're going to take home $5,000. All right? 15 seconds on the clock, please. The time will begin after I finish reading the first question. Good luck. Name something specific you wear when you dress casually.
Shorts.
A color of parakeets.
Green.
Something found at the North Pole.
Eskimos.
A language you learn in school.
Spanish.
The best TV night of the week.
Tuesday.
That's five. Turn around and let us see how you did. All right. I asked you to name something specific you wear when you dress casually. You said shorts. Our survey said four. You made the survey. A color of parakeets. You said green. Our survey said 50.
All right.
Made up for it. Something found at the North Pole. You said Eskimos. Our survey said zero. Obviously, there were no Eskimos in that survey. All right. A language you learn in school. You said Spanish. Our survey said 48.
Right.
You're getting up there. The best TV night of the week. You said Tuesday. Our survey said 8. 110 points. You can go back with your family. Let's cover those answers as we bring in Steve's sister, Julie. Come on, Julie. Good luck to you. Julie, you need 90 points to win. Stand right here. You know how this works. I'm going to ask you the same five questions I asked your brother.
Mm-hmm.
You try to give me the most popular answer. If you hear this sound, it means you have duplicated his answer. I'll say try again, and you give me another answer.
Okay.
It's a little more difficult, so you have five more seconds on the clock,
good,
please. 20 seconds, please. Let's reveal once again the answers that Steve gave us. Good luck. Name something specific you wear when you dress casually.
Shorts.
Try again.
T-shirt.
A color of parakeets.
Yellow.
Something found at the North Pole.
Ice.
A language you learn in school.
Spanish.
Try
French.
Again. The best TV night of the week.
Thursday.
That is five. Yeah. Turn around. Let us see. Step right here. Let me get you right there. I asked you to name something specific you wear when you dress casually. You said T-shirt. Our survey said four.
Oh.
You made the survey. You and your brother. Four is your number. I asked you a color. The number one answer, coincidentally, was jeans. That is what people dress casually in. A color of parakeets. You said yellow. Our survey said 28. Very fine. Green was the number one answer. Something found at the North Pole. You said ice.
I did.
Our survey said 25. Snow was the number one answer. I asked you a language you learn in school. You said French. Our survey said 26. We're getting up there. One last question I asked you, the best TV night of the week. You said Thursday. If seven people agreed with you, you're going to take home $5,000. Our survey said you get the point. Just won $5,000. We're coming back, so don't go away.
Welcome.
Call the number on your screen or visit us online today.
Welcome back. Welcome back. Thank you for joining us today. The Holtrust family are taking home $5,444, and they're coming back tomorrow. I'm Ray Combs. Happy birthday, America, and we'll see you tomorrow on Family Feud.
Some of our departing families will receive Ricci's Art Deco Collection silver-plated picture frame. Meticulous hand craftsmanship by Italy's master silversmiths. Frame your memories with beauty and luster from Ricci. Codaphone's 1000 series telephone answering system. Beautiful styling, great features, fast forward, memo recording, beeperless remote from Codaphone. Sunny Delight, Florida Citrus Punch brand. Loving delights you like. Vitamin-rich Sunny Delight, now in frozen concentrate. Delicious Encore, 2 pound frozen entrees for family-sized appetites. When you want more, it's Encore in your grocer's freezer. Sylvania soft white light bulbs, guaranteed 5% longer life. Sylvania, where the best comes to life. New Nabisco Frosted Wheat Squares, crunchy, bite-sized, lightly frosted biscuits and shredded wheat for great nutrition, great taste. And a member of our studio audience will receive Orfor's Jewel Decanter, handcrafted and hand-blown from the finest full lead crystal from Orfor's. Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.